Let's go. Bang. Alright. Let's play some curses. Pretty stock curses list. Just added two Sorens. This card seems like pretty good from what I've seen. So, yeah, just I've actually run into Reanimator like 4 to my last 10 matches, so just gonna tilt off and hope to continue to run into them. Let's go. Hand sucks. Whoop. All right. This is just a chalice on one. It's not really that impressive. Keep bottom helm. Watch this be Reanimator, and I didn't keep a helm. Okay, Dark Writ. 3-outer, one time. Oof. Sucks. So close. Cause I'm probably dead on turn 3, right? So we have to just go to tomb. Yeah. They were probably dead on turn 3. Being on the play, it's busted. What do we have in the sideboard? 3 Opposition Agent, 3 Plague Engineer. And 3 Torpor Orb you can bring in. Cursed Totem. So. Oh, that's good for me. That's good for me, actually. Like. Alright, we have a shot, I think. They didn't like glimpse off, so that's pretty cool. Definitely a little sense of false hope here. So we just get Overwhelming Splendor. Oh, we got really lucky. They had a very weird Elves Hand. Now we can chalice on one. I'm pretty sure it's chalice one, right? I don't think it matters. I'm just Trinisphere, I guess. Can't imagine that this decision matters. But yeah, we have a lot to bring in. So we probably just cut ley lines, helm, maybe even Karns. Cool. Yeah, really fortunate. That's a really weird. I can tell you the last time I saw an alt hand that slow. So, yay for us, I suppose. What's bad? No, we want. Probably something like that. Maybe those 10. Like, what if we brought in those 10 and cut four ley lines? I mean, Sorin's pretty bad too. Sorin, Karnhelm. You can do something like that. Leave in your curses, cut the ley lines. Chalice isn't great, Rose Shepherd, but in general, it's like it could be good. Guess the question is like, what's better, like ley lines or Chalice? Karn just doesn't seem impressive. So, I don't know, let's try this. This is like my initial thought. We're up a game, so we have a little bit of leniency to sort of figure it out. And I don't think we'll do it with the, like a Chromox, but just so slow. Gotta keep this one. Putting back Curse. Because I'm gonna lose this land. I'm gonna be a ways off of casting it. So. Even if I draw Ancient Tomb, I go like Ancient Tomb Chalice, then like Opposition Agent and Trinseer, like I have enough to do. So. Alright. Dark Raid or Ancient Tomb or Chromox. Yeah, I guess I still have to do it. Just a little make me feel bad if they have Shepherd. Oof. That's like basically the worst thing to see. Well, the thing I just have to play main phase Opposition Agent. Like it's not like flashy, like oh gotcha, you know. But I just don't see Trinisphere doing much. They notably don't have black for like a trophy or a decay. Nope. Things are looking okay. Oof, do I really need Dryad? I think I named Dryad. It's getting close to them casting Hoof, right? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so I was named Dryad. Nice. Quick one now. About 10 minutes, not bad. Diajong, gotta face good players, not cool. Okay. At least it's an easy imprint for Chromox. Elves again, huh? Wow, all right, sure. Okay. Didn't suck. I guess we just do the same plan. Just cut 10 four drops. Something like that. I mean, that worked. Not overthink it. Pretty insane. They have to take Curse of Death's Hold, and then we get a Trinisphere. What did they take? A Trinisphere? Huh. Because they didn't play anything on one, I don't think I need to jam Curse of Death's Hold. But why wouldn't I guess? I guess they have Force of Vigor. It'd be pretty rough, but I mean, that was gonna get me anyway, so. Sure. Yeah, wow. And now I don't have to play Urborg to give him the second mana, which is good. That's probably the best draw in the deck. Maybe Plague Engineer, but. If they activate this, oh my god. Oh, okay. All right, it's a game. I guess they were just looking for a green mana. Maybe like Cradle Natural Litter or something. Okay. Yeah, they have to chump, chump, chump. So, all right, 2-0. It's a keep, right? Like, turn one Leyline, turn two Ancient Tomb. I'll keep the second one for a Chromox potentially, for, like getting off of Urza's Saga. It's rare that you need the second one, so. Why would Symbiote? Well, look at that. Ketria Triumph Pass. And then concede. Weird. Elves, and then Ketria Triumph concede. Weird. I feel like this is a match Thorn will be good in. Some, this is weird, wild stuff. Ketria Triumph, maybe, like, Opposition Agent seems good. Maybe Sudden Edicts aren't great. Yeah, like we have like the mauling. Yeah, I guess just try that. Maybe some like four color control deck with like a graveyard utilization. Oh, here's a Sorin. I'm gonna keep because we have Sorin. I can play it on turn three. We're really not that far off from casting Cruel Reality, right? We're 1 mana short. Kadria Triumph pass again. My favorite thing about this deck is you get to play a bunch of Relentless Swamps. Oh, Mana Bond. We could just be dead. We're not, okay. So it's just, oh, it's land. It's just land, huh? Like four color lands or something? Nature's Claim, you say? Echo. What's better for me? Probably just get this into play. All right, so now I know if they're Nature's Claim, who the fuck runs Nature's Claim? Like, why wouldn't you run Force of Vigor instead? So they took a natural draw step because they're just gonna echo anyway. So we get to replay Leyland of the Void. They do have this mana bond, so however many lands they're gonna hit with that. Mana Bond, Nature's Claim, though, huh? And they're not discarding. Weird. So we get in for two. Play a chalice on one. Can they be running Force of Will also? Depends how many blue cards. But if you're running like 30. Crop rotation. That resolves. This is pretty funny against Echo. Okay. Running a Boro. Okay. Hitting the loam, which they can use to get Grove back. Just to like get zombies, I guess. Let's see if they're gonna discard their hand. Yeah, put three lands into play. Okay, it's three zombies. What does this do? Oh, that triggers that. Okay. I was like, why is that coming up? And And you're revealing three mountains, including a tabernacle, which would favor me. Cool realities. So they're gonna have to sack a zombie each turn. This will let me draw and they lose. I feel like I want to make another 2-3 flying lifelink that just lands up it's like insanely well. And then we can do cruel reality or curse of fool's wisdom. Cruel reality, they have to sack, so they can't get into Sorin at all. And then next turn I can play this and take two less, like, less damage also. And they have a Boro for Field of the Dead, which is pretty funny. Yeah, so this will keep... Those on check. Draw a card. Sure. Okay, you sack a Zombo. But yeah, I guess it's free to Boro every turn, huh? Which is pretty funny. They bounce it just to put it in end of turn. See what they hit. So this that's what'll do damage to me. So this is gonna gain me F4 zombies. Wow. And then three triggers to do three to me. So that's just like a. So actually, I might lose to that. I need to hit a curse like this turn, right? Let's see what this is. So Trinisphere can come out now. Leyland of the Void. Do I want to reveal this? No. Well, that sucks for me, though. So they sack one, go to five tokens. They draw one, lose two, I gain two. Now that I know what I'm facing, do I sideboard any differently? Amaze. Oh, they drew with Waterlog Grove, so I gain two life. And they cycled again, so I gained two more life. Cast a gamble into Chalice. That's good for me. Next turn, I do get a token to block. So this is going to keep doing three, but I'll keep gaining two. I can cash this in now, which I think I will. Oof, they hit a wasteland. That's really unlucky for me. Wow, and they let me get that. Cash that bad boy in. So they're at 8 zombies. Go to 7 zombies. And I have 4 blockers. So I would take 6, but then I would gain just a bunch. Hitting a second Valor Cloud Exploration is pretty bad for me. How many wastelands did they hit? Yeah, 3 out of the 4. Multiple Field of the Deads. Oof. Oof. I guess a mana bonnet, like Chalice on Chalice seems like Chalice on one just like is just such a house, right? Like they're on Nature's Claim, Gambles, and Mana Bond. Oh man. So that's. Oh, I do get to attack in the air with the vampire tokens if I want to. For 4. So I just need to keep track of when I can, like, attack for lethal. I don't run, like, a Shadow Spear. They top decked Force of Vigor? What insanity! That was their draw. It was Force of Vigor. Wow. That's really unfortunate for me. Am I just dead? Like. If I play this, damn, what a brutal top deck. I don't think that was exiled, right? There's nothing in there. Alright. We're gonna take. Why didn't. So if they attack next turn, I don't have a way to get rid of these last 2 points, it seems. So I have to attack for 1. Attack with one of these. So they have 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I attack with 1, but they sack 1, they go to 10. So they're going to have 20 attacking, and I'm at 13. Point power. With 10 zombies attacking, I could block 1, 2, 3, 4 of them if I do that. So 6 get through, do 12 to me. And I'm going to be at 13, and then Valakut Exploration kills me. Oh no, but then I'll gain 4 from the blocks. Yeah. It's weird. Yeah, definitely didn't play around them hitting a Force of Vigor. I don't think I could have. Yeah, how would I board differently? I have to take out the those don't matter. Echo matters. I'm gonna bring like Plague Engineer. Okay. Okay. It's gonna be close. They did it like triple exploration off of that though. Four damage from that. So I'll basically see their whole deck for whatever it's worth. Only seen the one Force of Vigor, one Nature's Claim. Is that really it? Multiple mana bonds, which is pretty wild. Yeah, 'cause they have six. What is this? That's four damage there. So I block. Think, am I like exactly dead? Take 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and I'm gaining four. I just attack them for six in the air now, right? Oh no, does this trigger that? Oh, okay, so I see. You can stack it. So once the beginning of the end step trigger goes on, it's like all sees the same thing. Okay. That's how they win. Okay, I got it. I got it now. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, Edict doesn't do anything. Really just need Chalice on one for I didn't even see Mox Diamond. Huh? All right, so let's just go for yeah. I guess needle. Could bring a plague engineer for zombie. They can't remove a plague engineer actually. Just like I can't remove a Valakut Exploration. What in needle? I guess you need to like a Burrow or Wasteland. That's probably pretty loose. Let's just try this. It's a weird, weird deck. Pretty cool though. Yeah, so I was always thinking, like, if you fetch on your opponent's turn, you wait till then, but it just puts a trigger on the stack and doesn't care, like, when they got there by the time it resolves, so. Definitely not the nuts. Like, this needs to be a swamp. Let's hope they don't have turn one mana bond again. Though this could probably be a turn one mana bond. Probably getting Force of Vigor. God, what I would do for an opposition agent right here. I could have also just went Chalice on one opposition agent. Yeah, they have the Nature's Claim. Oh. All right, they're at nine. Well. They had another loam, a grove. Had a wasteland and a cave. Three Valakut explorations, holy shit. Do 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 do. 3-0, wild, wild game though. What a weird cool deck. Yeah. Yeah, but no Mox Diamonds, huh? Just Mana Bond and like really leaning. Lean into the Valakut exploration, but no Mox Diamond to like accelerate it, which is pretty interesting. Wow. 3 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute, 1 minute. Then a 1 minute, 7 minute, 8 minute. Alright, well, 3-0. The one time I got Soren in play, it was my only chance to win versus all them zombies. I mean, maybe the other turn I could have attacked for like that 2 damage. I don't know. Or, you know, however much damage and gain the life, I'm not sure. But Cruel Reality is embarrassing versus Field of the Dead. And multiple Field of the Deads. Like, Metabon, multiple Field of the Dead, multiple Alcat Explorations. Fuck me up pretty badly. All right, round 4. I'm gonna assume it's like elves. I mean, goblins, because it's 61. I'm keeping though. It has a good fair start. I could also just make. I can get a turn 1 curse if I top deck it. I could turn 1 edict. Get rid of Dark Ritual Chromox. Play Saga. Like, edict you. This is just a fair deck. I could just play Saga. Say go. Just like hold back. I can go for turn 1 Trinisphere. I can Chromox the sudden edict. I think that was the best way to play it. Yeah. That feels like a good way to play it. I was probably just on, like, whatever, banned garbage. See if they have another Uro. They got rid of one, so they may have another one. Them fetching there, to me, indicates that they're looking for something, which is good. Punishing Fire. Sure. All right. Yeah, just some greed pile control deck. Just Saga wins. So that feels good. This is a match that I wanted to see how Soren was Soren would do against, so. Opposition agent seems great, and edict seems trash. Something like that. Could want a needle to get off of Saga more than edict, maybe? Let's try that. Maybe. I don't know. Let's see how many creatures they play. Leyline seems good against a Punishing Fire Uro deck. A real bitch to ending. And even if they remove it later, just the fact that like they have to use removal on it eventually, and all these cards are not going into the graveyard to fuel an escaped Uro, so. I would love a force wall on this. Because that means they don't have force of vigor. So. They shuffle from that ponder? They didn't shuffle. So it's not like they're like completely out of land drops. Unless they didn't shuffle because there was a force and still missing lands. No, there they go. Okay. This will protect my Curse of Misfortune. Wow, just all the forces. I got rid of a Jace though. Again, that these are wins, I think. Just got to cast like two Hymn to Turox. And we have like another one here that requires a force, so like look at all these cards. They're just like all so powerful. Oh man. I was gonna say Wasteland is the only thing that I may be bothered by. Wow, really? Right, let's throw a swamp out there, I guess. And they don't shuffle. Iteration? Has to be iteration, right? Yeah. See if they find a land. Nope. Wow. They found one, two, three, four forces. That's too funny. Can you beat a saga also? Wild. Jeez. Multiple wastelands. All right, can I win through four Force of Wills and double Wasteland? Yep, that's game. I'm actually not even gonna play the Chalice on one. My life's getting pretty low. I'd rather just make two constructs. Oh, okay, never mind. We just win. Nice. And we even got the Pithy Needle Abandon Hope flavor. All right. Well, let's head into match five. Yeah, so far the deck's felt pretty good. Felt pretty good. So Sorin was originally in this list I found was a Profane Tutor. Trying to think about the times we had it. Profane Tutor may have been better. So I don't know. I just wanted to see like in like see how it would have been. Like in that last match I couldn't cast Zorn, but I would have been able to suspend, so it's like but in general, you know, like this is really good. And if they have a force, I'd rather them like force my 4 mana thing than the thing I spent like 2 mana, way 2 turns and 4 mana on, so I don't know. So elves, lands, control. Oh, man. Alrighty, Rue. Here we go. Been on the draw a lot. Which isn't super. So let's see if that matters or not. Oof, man. Trop Ponder. I think we want a Dark Writ Trinisphere against that. Well, now we can. I think I want to turn one Trinisphere. Mox, Imprint, Dark Ritual. Ancient Tomb, Trinisphere, next turn Swamp Karn. I could imprint Curse of Deathhole. I could play a Karn this turn, but if it like if they have force, obviously. The thing is, if Trinisphere resolves, or say they let Trinisphere resolve and wasteland me, I'm pretty screwed. This is tough, really, depending on what they're playing. I'm assuming it's probably like a Bant control deck, and they've been running Wasteland, like two of them. So this sequencing is really important. Like, what do we want to imprint? We can imprint like Sudden Edict, then Dark Rite Trinasir, and then just play a Swamp. Like, some are good against Ending and some are good against Wasteland. So it's. You can also just run Karna, but nah, there's no way Trinasir isn't just the best, right? They could be an Omni, right? Like Blue and Omni, in which case you want to hold Trini so you could put it in and off the show and tell. It's like. But then. What do you do? You're just running out Karn. It's really difficult. It's really difficult. They're 3-1 also. I imprint Sudden Edict. Just put this and see what happens. Maybe with my tanking, they like force negation this or something bananas. Okay. So let's get rid of. I think Curse of this hole. Oh, it goes in. It's in. All right. Sick, sick, sick. Was not expecting that. We'll take it. Grab local metal coating. See if we can lock them under the Trinasphere. Then fetching is good. Ending the Trinasphere. So I was right in what they were playing. Worst draw on our deck. So they had two draw steps to hit a force. Nice. All right. All right. Think played that pretty well. Good, good, good. Read the situation well and all right. So it's yeah, just control pile. So against this deck, I've cut the Sudden Edicts for the opposition agents and Pithing Needle. And that seemed pretty to work out well, so. It's just a random bug control, four color control, whatever. I think it's fine. Yeah, I'll keep this. There's a lot of things they have to force, so. What I like. I don't even know what I like. A Chromox wouldn't be bad. Dark Red. Trinisphere. All right, Dark Red is like one turn soon, but that's definitely something that's not dead. Let me just go land go. Cruel reality. Brainstorming in response to the dark, it's good. Okay. And that's why Dark Root was good though. It like made them have to have a force negation on turn two, so Teferi would be pretty irritating. I think I'm actually gonna wait a turn now. With that being the draw. I don't want to sack my City of Traders when I have a 5-minute play. Yeah, Baleful Strix confirms they're just some sort of a 4-color control, so. I'm just going to be acute. I'm just going to try to punk them. See if they waste any removal on this. That other city is actually insane, right? It lets me cast this. So here, if they like do a fawn. Now this attack's like a Jace or something, so that feels good. Being able to pressure like a Planeswalker potentially. So they had land, so they're holding four soil. A Plague Engineer? Sure. Plague Engineer resolves. You got it. They only have one black source, so could do something like named Servo. Basically, just gonna we just have like non-stop force of willable things. Like they'll have to force this, and they'll have to force Karn, and they'll have to force Crow Reality. So, yep. They pitched a so this is four forces. Sure. Can we went through we went through four forces earlier. Can we went through four more? Are they just gonna ending library? What do you got? Ending my agent or ending on the ley line? Sure. Ooh, Wasteland. Wasteland, my city that I've been. Oh, that's. Oh, man, that's so good. All right, well. I'll make it so you have one turn. To produce your fifth force of will. See if they hit force will number five. So we'll just do it on upkeep. Got it. The trophy. Nice. Nice clean. What was that one game loss to the Wildlands player. So that's cool. That's cool with a nice quick Ligarino. Yeah, deck was good. I didn't face Reanimator, which was like one of the readers I wanted to play this today. Burn, gobble, burn. Were you return to details? Which player were you? Were you the Ar something grief? That you? Burn, gobble, burn. GG, if we did play. Yeah, which deck were you? I'm just curious because I might have a. Legacy Goblins. What's up? How are you today? Yep, got the trophy. Got the trophy. Pretty honestly, like the deck just ran so smoothly. Elves, which were a breeze, with Plague Engineers, Opposition Agents, Curse of Deathhold. Lands was wild. Yeah, sweet. And I got to play new Sorin. Though that's the only reason I wanted to play this deck. I said, what deck could Sorin go into? And it's this one. Yeah, it's nice. Because, I mean, the Sorin tick up, honestly, is like. These are all cheap, right? Like, 36 cards are dirt cheap. And every once in a while, you hit, like, a 4 or something. But even making a 2/3 lifelink, like, flyer, it's very reasonable. And then sideboard, just agents and engineers. Torpor Orbs for D&T and Doomsday. So the deck's just real strong. Like we went through four Force Wills twice. I mean it's just like Hardcast Force Pitch Force this, Force that. Like, all right, here's something else. Like if you look at like the things that are must to force, it's like 12, it's at 20% of our deck. So they need to have it. So I'm gonna open some chests, and then I'll call it. I just wanted to have a nice league. I haven't played this deck in months, so it was definitely nice to just bang out a quick 5-0. 11 chesties. Let's open some Ragavans and Solitudes and Endurances and whatnot, huh? I did open a Ragavan. I just got paid $100 to. to win this league. That's pretty awesome. That just yes. Thank you very much. All right. I'm calling it. That was phenomenal. All right, everyone, have a good night and follow the stream if you didn't. Check out